beach fishing North Narrabeen with my mate Laurie. So here we are down at a busy Sydney beach. It's about 7 o'clock in the morning and we're going to have a go for whiting. We've got some lovely fresh beach worms. Just going to go enjoy the morning. It's a light wind blowing, so we're going to head on over. Let's go, Loz.
See how we go. Looks fantastic.
In this video, I'm specifically fishing for delicious whiting, and I'm going to teach you everything that I do.
We caught these beach worms yesterday afternoon about 5 o'clock so that we could have some bait for this morning, and they're really fired up. We just kept them in a cool place at home overnight, and yeah, they're in really good condition. So I'm going to put that worm bait on there, like that, and then, oops.
Woo, look at that.
Look at that guy. Man, how much energy have they got?
I think they're still alive, Rog.
Yeah, I think so.
You want a bite?
Oh, Laurie.
Man, I'm going to get a bite.
Spaghetti.
Wee, wee.
Spaghetti worms.
Yep.
Now, there's a gentleman who was already down here before us, which is typical in busy city beaches. So we're going to actually fish as far to the left as possible. We're fishing right in the corner. If he wants to come and have a chat, well, then we'll just try and work out between us to, you know, respectfully fish next to each other, not too close, I guess. Anyway, I'm going to walk and chuck my line out, Laurie, because I am ready to go, and I'm keen to see if there's anything going to bite.
Let's do it.
Okay, there's a little bit of wash out there. Alrighty. So, Laurie, there's a little bit of a wash that's going from the left to the right. Just a little bit. You can see where the rocks are there, the dark patch. It's sand just in front of us. You've probably actually got a chart. Actually, maybe you go on my right-hand side. Cast a little bit to the right. Cast a little bit to the right.
Are you pulling to the left at all?
It looks like it. It's weird because the current's going that way. If you cast on a bit of an angle over that way, just behind the waves. Where did you land?
Straight out there. At this point.
Yeah, it's kind of funny.
Wind is pushing me hard to the left.
Yeah, I think what it is I don't want to be right on those rocks. We've probably got to stand about 5 or 10 feet to the right. I might wind in and chuck out again.
I've got a feeling.
I've got a fish, Laurie.
Already?
Yeah. Yeah, I got one straight away. How's that?
Okay.
How quick was that? Actually, you're over me, yep. He feels good, Laurie. He's not a baby.
Okay.
What if I got more than one? What have I got here?
An oogly.
It's a good fish, Laurie.
Yeah, I can see that.
It's a crazy cracker. Look at the size of that. Look at the... Oh, he's a beast!
Oi.
He is an absolute monster.
Oh, walk back, mate.
I will. I've just got to wait for this wave. How big is this whiting? This whiting is huge. Watch out for your leg. I got two! That's why it's... Oh, watch out. Hey, Laurie, I got two.
That's why it felt big.
That's what I got, two massive whiting. Oh my gosh.
A double header.
Look at the size of this.
Massive whiting.
Look at that.
What
a cracker. Oh my gosh.
Typical Roger.
I got a double hook up here. Get a load of the size of that whiting. That's nuts. Two at once, first cast.
So ladies and gentlemen, that's how you do it.
I've got to go and put these in my bucket.
Little brother. Well, not as big as Roger, still a beautiful species. I'm gonna let this one go. Beautiful whiting. Come on, fella. There we go. Hey. You want your freedom, you don't do that. There we go. Back from all sultanas.
Good morning. How are you doing? First cast, would you believe?
Bloody hell, that's a bigger.
That's big whiting. Hey look, we'll try and keep out of your hair as much as possible.
That's right, I'm on this side, don't worry.
But we can fish here together.
Yes, that's a great whiting.
Would you believe that? Because I've got a double hook set up. And did Laurie catch one? Small one. But all you got to do, what's your name?
Robert.
If necessary, Robert, when you cast, walk out just a little bit further, just so that your bait just lands just behind where the waves are breaking. That's where you want to get. How's that for a first cast? One of those guys is big.
Oh, I saw that.
He's a beast.
Lovely whiting. I did the same. I got one straight away, but it was only small.
Okay.
So I threw him back. But clearly they're there. How's that, eh? Bottom of the tide.
Okay, well, I'd like to have another dose of that, mate. They're beautiful to eat, those.
Oh, yeah.
Be fantastic.
What a beautiful morning.
We've come down here. It's actually blowing a southerly.
Yes.
Which is in our face.
Yeah, but it's coming straight out.
It's not a heavy southerly. So, I mean, if it was blowing an absolute... You could still fish here if it was blowing an absolute gale, but... You know, it's certainly not hindering us from fishing. Okay, let's see how we go. I want to line up again. I'm not that far out behind the waves. When you cast out, Laurie, go to the right of me because you know how that wind's kind of pushing us into the corner a bit.
You want me on the right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So see where those guys are in those kayaks? I'm kind of in that direction, on a slight angle to the right.
You are?
No, you are when you cast out.
Oh, okay.
Out.
Right, sorry.
Because that's roughly where I cast. Tell you what, there must be some fish out there.
Well, either that or they had their mouth open when you cast. Look!
Man, I've actually got a measuring tape in my bag.
Oh, that first one was a huge one. You only thought you had one on, there was two there.
I know! I'm thinking this is hard to pull in.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, that's a good spot, Loz. I'm actually not very far out. Where we're fishing here is right up hard against the rocks in the corner of the beach because the whole beach is featureless. It has no holes, no gutters, nothing. But at least in the corner of the beach we can get into the off the edge into the trough. And we've got the wind coming straight at us this way. But that first cast certainly showed that there was some quality whiting in there. My bait probably only landed about 2 or 3 metres behind where the waves break on the edge, pretty close. But if I don't get a bite in the next minute, I'm going to cast it just a fraction further out. You landed in a good spot, Laurie. I kind of didn't quite go out as far as you.
Yeah. Well, I might slowly bring it in.
You know, Laurie, that first cast where I had those two whiting, I actually just went to wind it in.
Yes, and they were there.
Because I thought, I think it's drifting over towards the rocks a little bit.
You didn't even strike, it was there.
The bottom one had swallowed the hook.
Yeah.
The top one hadn't swallowed the hook, but the bottom one had.
I think you woke them up. They just got out of bed and just went, oh.
That's right, yeah. It's pretty cool, though. It's awesome when you can do this, isn't it? You
know? Absolutely.
Doesn't matter
where
you are.
What is that thing out there in the water?
You can be in the big city or you can be in the country, doesn't matter. Oh. I think I'm going to chuck this back out again because I'm just looking to see if I can see where your line is. Oh yeah, I can see where your line is.
I'm directly in line with that thing sticking up in the water way out there.
Yeah. I'm just going to come in underneath.
What do you reckon that is?
It's a buoy of some kind.
A buoy?
Yeah. It's only out about 500 metres. I've actually got to walk out a little bit to the edge to get my weight, my bait in the zone where I want it to be. So I'm not getting lots of bites. I had those two fish immediately. It's going to pull my line in just a little bit. These sorts of places are normally very good where you have a entrance of a lake, etc. The entrance of the lake behind me, they're doing work in the lake and they've actually piled sand up and they've closed the entrance of the lake. But normally you get a trickle of water coming out here and all the fish sit out here and wait for all the food to come out of the lake. So it's a very good place to fish anywhere up and down the coast like this. I'm going to actually cast my line out again because I haven't had a bite. And if you toss out a worm and it lands near a whiting, they're going to nail it. So I haven't lost any bait. Although my bottom bait looks like it might have been just touched. Okay, so I'm going to go for a little wander. Hey, look, our friend's got a whiting. How awesome. Woohoo! He's obviously using worms as well. It's good that it's overcast, I think. I'm sure. I like it when it's overcast. Come on, Mr. Whiting. I love this light, Laurie. It's really, really cool. Yes.
The fish can't tell whether the sun's coming up or not at the moment, which is good.
Because of those clouds, yeah. So I know some of our good friends who are very good whiting fishermen, they actually even knock off once the sun comes over the
horizon. That's it, they go home.
They go home.
Yeah, coffee time.
Yeah.
That's right. They're here before now.
I'm excited about eating those whiting, mate.
Rog, I'll give you a hand.
Here, fish.
Got to be more than three there, surely.
Yeah, because you had a bite pretty quickly after me.
Yeah, it took a little while.
They can't have travelled very far.
No.
Or, you know, we could even try, you know, because we've just got this little section here where the surfers are, where the waves are breaking and you've got a right-hand wave coming into the corner here. We could actually... Yeah, I don't know. We could try anywhere along that edge, although to do so we'd have to get on the other side of this fisherman and fish on the opposite side, casting that way. The water's a little bit deeper over there.
It is. Your line's... Is that you?
No, that's his line.
Oh, okay.
See how mine's just near you? See how mine's coming down near you and it's kind of bowing around?
Yeah,
it's just in this little...
Got it. I might... I don't want to get snaggled up on those rocks, but I'd like to try into that little pocket there because I've got a feeling that's where...
Well, I was kind of drifting over that way when I got those fish.
Yeah. Well, you're...
I'm over you, I'm pretty sure. I am. You're under me.
Yeah, okay, good. I've got a feeling they're going to be tucked next to the rocks.
Maybe. You know, when I've been spearfishing, I've seen a lot of whiting in different places right up against... on the sand, right up against the rocks. I've seen that a lot.
Yeah, well, I'm going to put on a slightly heavy sinker so that I don't drift into the rocks.
Okay.
And target specific the edge.
All right. I'll look after it while you're gone, Laurie.
We got a visitor.
Oh, we got a visitor.
It's Tony. Hey.
Yeah, it's good to see you, mate. It's been a few years, actually.
Yeah, you've been down the south coast there.
Yeah, it's beautiful. You'd love it. You really would, because it's just like endless beaches. Endless, honestly, the options for rock and beach fishing, you would literally wet yourself. It's amazing.
Yeah. Oh, we're still very privileged here on the northern beaches. Oh. So we have plenty of options and things. So.
Yeah, you know, I mean, if I was living here, I mean, as a fisherman, it's exciting. And I know, you know, you keep good company.
Oh, yes. Oh, I'll put a quick finger on the pulse in terms of what's happening in the estuaries and on the beach and rocks and things. So.
Yeah.
And I still love it. So.
Oh, yeah. Why not? It's good for you.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, they were pretty good a couple of weeks ago, the fish on the beach. They've just they're just slowed down a little bit. It's a little bit hard with the tide this morning's pretty low. So.
Yeah. We just thought we'd come down and fish in the corner and have a go in the corner, because along the beach, Laurie was saying that there was a gutter at, you know, up near Emerald Street up there, but it's kind of disappeared.
Yeah.
And there's really no features hardly. I mean, at high tide you could fish there, but...
Well, normally this beach has a really long trench or gutter that goes right along it.
Yeah.
But over the last few months it's been pretty well sanded up, other than that little gutter that you were referring to.
That one spot, yeah.
But with the southerly and that, it's a bit blown out as well and that, so it's a bit featureless now.
Yeah, so as you know, it's just always changing all the time, you know. Well, I'm going to go and chuck it back in again.
No, good first cast.
Yeah, I know. That was great. You know, double hook up, you know, on a couple of decent whitings, so that was good.
Oh, it's crazy. When I was down with Laurie about a month ago,
yeah,
we fished for an hour and a half for nothing.
Yeah.
Laurie got 6 in 5 casts.
Yeah.
Including a double.
So after you'd fished for an hour and a half?
After we fished for an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Laurie got 6 in 5 casts, including a double header.
Yeah.
Some reasonable quality on the worms. And then they went quiet, and I did okay on the yabbies thereafter.
Yeah.
They definitely slowed a bit, but they were pent up in the lake here. So it's a very late season. Normally it's in November, December.
Yeah, when talking to Chris, he normally likes to fish around December. Well, good to see you, Tony.
No worries. You take care.
Yeah, thanks, mate. I'm gonna get my legs wet. And hopefully I can add to that.
This gentleman got a lovely one.
Yeah, he did. That's awesome.
They'll be in close.
Yeah.
If the waves can let you hold it there.
Yeah, that's it. I've only got a little ball sinker on.
Okay.
But
you take care.
Thanks, mate. Try over this side. I don't mind getting a little bit wet when I'm down the beach, especially in summertime. The tide should be coming in, actually. It is coming in, so I wonder how that's going to affect things. So I'm all the way over here, and Laurie's all the way over there. Drifting, I mean, and my ball sinker is being carried from the right to the left. So it's just, I'm not holding the bottom at all here. And now there's a big set of waves coming in.
Oh.
Laurie's got one, I think.
What do we have here?
Looks like a good fish, actually.
Stop the bus. Oi. What have I got here? I don't think this is a whiting. I'm not sure what this is. If this is a whiting, it's a killer.
Well, it looks like Laurie's is pretty solid. Oh, stingray. The little stingray. Must be a pretty light rod that he's using.
I think that's what you call losing points. Ah, well. All right, just hang tight, little fella. We'll get you out of here.
Just having a little go here in this shallow water. It's just a very small amount of, just a couple of feet deep, really. Just a little tiny channel. Just want to see if there's anything in there. I fish down here heaps of times with the surfers, and the surfers don't bother the fish. You know, whether you're fishing here in the morning or the afternoon really doesn't matter. And it doesn't matter if there's 50 surfers out there, you'll still catch fish. All right, I'm going to head back over to where Laurie is and have a chat. Haven't had any bites over here. My baits are both still intact. Hey, Laurie. Sorry about, it's a shame about the stingray, mate.
Oh, that's all right.
You know, I think low tide was about 6:45. Oh, a bit of a bite.
Whoa, that's
good bite.
Fierce bites, yeah.
Fierce bite, huh?
No hook up though. Wonder why. Might have bit me off. Oh, I might have it. No, I've got it.
You got it? Whiting. Yeah, nice. Yes.
He's a keeper. Smile for the camera, buddy.
Okay, well, Laurie's added to the tally. That's good.
He's healthy. Decent size. But there's bigger ones there, I'm sure. No point in wasting the bait.
Oh, I'm getting a bite. I got him. Okay, so that didn't take too long to get a bite. That's good. Doesn't feel as big as the other one, although I had two on at once last time, so... I think I'll just walk over this way, because that other guy's line is behind me. I think I might... where am I? If you just lift your rod up, I'll walk underneath. Just lift it up. Yeah. I had a bite pretty quickly then, Laurie. I had a bite pretty quickly.
Yeah, so did I. His line's over in the corner.
Yeah, and I think that the current has just dragged... The current has just dragged it across. So I'm going to go and add this to our little tally.
Yep, okay. It's about that big. He's got a fish. It was whacking me in the ankles.
You got a bite?
They're onto it straight away.
Where did you cast, Laurie? Where did you cast?
In the water.
In the water. Ha 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 ha. Just on the edge?
Yeah, just to the right.
Okay. There's obviously a few in there, Laurie.
Oh, yeah. That last one just bang, bang, got me. One bite, gone.
Knocked it off. The last one I had swallowed the hook pretty quick.
Yeah. I think what's happening is they're probably milling around in big schools. And all of a sudden they'll just go all over your baits. You'll get two or three, and then they'll move off again, then they'll come around, they'll circle around again.
Yeah. Mate, that beautiful white whiting flesh is just sweet.
Very delicate flesh, beautiful.
This young girl's catching lots
yeah,
of waves.
Yeah, I'm noticing her. She's quite a good rider.
She is. She's a good surfer.
She's practicing for a circuit, I'd say.
So, Laurie, what weight line have you got on your reel?
9 pound.
9 pound.
Yeah, just in the local tackle store, it's just nine pound. Oh, what do they call it? Bulk line.
And what about your leader? What weight
that's
leader?
That's 10 pound fluorocarbon.
10 pound fluorocarbon.
In that what they call a rock.
FC rock or whatever.
Yeah,
it
that's
is.
It. And just a small number 4 hook.
Number 4, okay.
Yeah. Bait keeper.
Bait keeper. Has it got the little barbs on it? Okay.
Yep.
Did you get a bite?
I missed it.
Okay.
At least I think I did. Why not?
Ah, you didn't miss it, Laurie.
I thought I missed it. Do you want to keep it?
Well, it's big enough. It's legal, I can tell by looking at it. But he swallowed the hook, so you're going to have to kill him
I'm
anyway.
I'm going to have to keep it. He swallowed the hook right down. It's big enough. All right, I'll be back.
While there's not millions of bites, we're getting a reasonably consistent run of whiting. Certainly some beautiful fish for eating. I'm looking forward to that already. I think I got a bite then. My line's gone slack. I think that was it. Yeah, I'm getting a bite. So I'm just gonna let him bite for a minute so that he swallows it. Oh no, he hasn't swallowed it. I thought he would swallow it, but he hasn't. I definitely had a bite. Maybe I should have struck. But I didn't strike. I thought I'm gonna let him just swallow the worm, but he didn't swallow it. Here's a bite. Oh, I got him this time. So I opted to strike that time rather than hope it swallows it. I have another double hookup. Hey Laurie, you got a double banger, double bunger. Look, I got one on the top, one on the bottom. Another double hookup. Look at that. Woo!
Oh wow. You know what, Rog?
What?
You're
what,
a show-off.
Look at that, what a cracker. Fantastic.
Okay, I've just had a bite and it's hooked up. It's coming in, it feels pretty strong. And yes, I think, yep, it's another whiting.
He's a nice fish, Laurie.
Yeah, he's a good fish.
Yeah, good fish.
Only one though, not like you, you show off.
Well, you can put another hook on, but
I've only got one hook.
Yeah, yeah, I'm kind of pushing it.
Look at that, this is crazy.
Well, they're certainly biting now. We arrived here right on low tide, so the tide has changed. It started coming in, so the first of the run-in tide is very often an excellent time to fish for whiting. And that's proving to be the case this morning. So I'm just going to whack my line back out there again. We caught these worms locally. There's an abundance of worms on the northern beaches, really, heaps. No shortage. So I'm going to leave that whole bit on, that nice little curly tail. I'm just going to put that whole bit out there. So a fish couldn't resist that. Where did you land, Loz? I know, in the water. I know.
Out the back.
Out the back. Okay, I'm just going to look and see where your line is. Okay. Gotta make sure I don't get in the way of the other fishermen. Gonna give this a little flick just beyond the edge.
My goodness, look at the size of the worm bait he's using.
Probably about there.
Like half a worm.
Yeah, that's a good spot. We'll give that a go.
In the sweet spot. This time for sure. Big baits, you got big baits on the long tails.
I do have pretty big baits. Well, we're not low on worms, so...
Yeah, well, that's it.
You know, it doesn't really matter too much.
I'm trying for... The bait was still on the hook. It was a bit mangled, and I thought, let's try it again and see if it works the second time.
Yeah. So there was enough worm on there.
Well, just enough. We'll have a go. If it doesn't prove to be successful in a few minutes, I'll change it. But I just thought I'd see if I can get a second fish on the same bait. That's almost like getting two on the one.
Yeah. Oh, right, yes. I don't always fish with two hooks. I do quite often, but...
Yeah, I used to do that all the time, and it was very successful.
Well, I've had two double hookups this morning.
I know.
And the first one I got was like, it's like that big.
Oh, it's a beauty.
It's a monster. The other ones are just a great size for eating. They're not very far out, are they, Laurie? Just in the edge of the wash.
Yeah, there's plenty there. They're a decent size. It's a good school.
I'll tell you what, mate, after this fish, go home, just have some really nice coffee.
Oh. Yep.
Really nice coffee. Just, I don't know, maybe something to munch on.
Well, what do you reckon? Whiting for breakfast or what? Lunch?
No, not for breakfast, I don't think. I didn't realise I had two fish on that last time. I definitely felt some bites and I was just waiting.
Yeah, well, that's what I thought. I thought I got, there's something tapping, but it swallowed it.
Yeah. You know, as that tide comes in, like if the tide was higher, you'd probably be getting them right up here.
Yeah.
I would say.
You would, definitely.
But Tony was saying it's been a bit quiet the last couple of weeks.
Not this morning.
No.
Certainly starting to pull a bit hard now.
I came down here with a friend one afternoon. Oh, hang on, I'm getting a bite. I'm getting a bite.
To be continued. There he is. There he is. There he is. He's all over it.
I know, I might have two now, Laurie, because I waited.
Yes, I
saw
that.
I gave him time to actually... Sometimes what my dad used to do is he'd get a bite and he'd hook a fish and then he'd wait.
Yeah.
When he's got two hooks for another one to get on.
Yeah. Uh-oh, I'm all over it, unless Roger's got me.
Oops.
Rog, I think...
Yeah, I am.
Something going there.
I think I am over you, Laurie.
Yep.
I only have one, Loz. Nice whiting, though. So that's just your beautiful classic size whiting. We've got a couple of bigger ones in there, but... cracking fish. That one would probably be about 34 centimetres maybe, guesstimating. So they're still biting. Okay, just checking where you are. I'm going to go to the right a little bit.
Yeah, I'm pretty much straight out there.
Just wait for these couple of waves to do their thing. I just want to get out beyond that breaking wave. All the bait and all the goodies are just getting sucked out beyond that, just into that trough. Yeah, that's good.
I'm a little tangled here.
A little tangled. I'm just going to get on your other side.
Okay, what's happened here? Oh, it's tied itself in a knot. Okay.
I'm on again, Laurie.
What on earth went... Okay. Okay. Well, yep, this is one of my rigs, ladies and gentlemen. Just call me Tangles. Oh dear. I'm in trouble. Oh, go away.
This guy swallowed it as well.
Oh dear. There's light at the end of the tunnel. But it's a long tunnel. Nah, I'm going to have to re-rig. This is dead. Okay, well, this could be the last one for the morning. There he is. Look at him go. In you come. Surfing the whiting. Yee-hoo! Oh, yeah, your little one. Well, I'll let this one go, I think. So I've redeemed myself after the tangle, but I think I'll let this guy have his freedom because he's a little small. Oh, he swallowed it right down. You know what? I'm just going to cut the line and I'm going to let him go. There you go, fella. He gone. Tide's coming in quick.
It is. It's actually a good tide to be fishing. The first 2 hours of the run in for the whiting is actually a very good time.
Yeah.
So which is essentially that's what we're fishing.
That's what's happened, yeah.
Okay. See, it's getting harder to stand out here, isn't it?
Yes.
It's getting deeper.
I just can't stand it anymore. We're getting quite wet, but that's okay. As long as we're still catching fish, you put up with a lot.
I like watching our friends in South Africa. I love that. You know, because, you know, I don't care if I get wet. I'll go out up to my neck, you know, in the warm weather. But the guys in South Africa, mate, they wear rash vests and board shorts or wetsuits. And to get their baits in the good water, they'll swim out to here.
Serious?
Yeah. I think it's awesome.
They've got to be careful. They'll become the bait.
Oh, I love it. I'd do that every day of the week. Okay, Loz, let's get out there.
Well, there we go.
I think we might be a little close to each other. That's all right. If we get crossed over, we can always fix it up.
Figure it out, yeah.
I think that the bites have improved as the tides come in. Because it was a little bit slow to begin, but then we were getting a lot more consistent bites.
Yeah, yeah.
I guess we'll fillet those fish at your place.
Yeah, do that.
I think I might have a fish on. My line's gone slack. I had a couple of bites.
I got washed in the whole way then.
I had some nibbles then. Not sure what's going on. I think I might wind my line in.
Now, that's not unusual for you, Rog.
Wind my line in.
I'm not sure what's going on.
Just hang over here for a second. Hey, we're going to wrap it up now because we've had an awesome session.
It's been good.
It's 8:30. We probably got down here and started fishing about just before 7 a.m. Just after sunrise. So we've been here for about an hour and a half. We've had an awesome time. Caught lots of beautiful whiting. I trust this video has been a help to you. Make sure that you like and subscribe. Subscribing doesn't cost anything. It's free and it really helps my channel. So it'd be great if you've been watching my videos and you enjoy them, make sure that you subscribe. And we'll be back at you really soon with another adventure. Hey, Laurie.
That's for sure.
Yeah.